afternoon, happy Friday. I'm Kildavid, your host for the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play featuring Grand Theft Auto Online, the Chop Shop DLC. This is going to be gaming live stream walkthrough number 8. And we're continuing on with the salvage yard business, aka the Chop Shop. As of yesterday, Thursday, the weekly DLC update dropped for GTA Online, and we got some new missions concerning the salvage yard. So, without any further ado, I'm going to continue with the cargo ship robbery 2, part 2, part 1 and part 2. So grab a snack, grab a drink, but whatever, it's time for Let's Play Classic. Let's Play GTA Online. Here we go. Thank you. Alright. I don't know for what reason this happens. I ended up having to reboot the game. But here we go. Hope everyone's having a good afternoon. You got all your Christmas and holiday shopping done already? Good. If you don't, also good. Hope you got plans. I've got plans. So, as I mentioned before, there's actually a second cargo ship robbery. But at least it's of a different vehicle this time. I would have loved to see another one, but that's what the third car is going to be. So this will either be a part one and a part two combined, or it'll be separate for the cargo ship two, part one. But it's still episode 8. If there's a follow-up, it'll be episode 9. But it looks like the setup is going to be the same when it comes to the cargo ship robbery. Because we're probably going to be using the same approach. Because I know we got to get another, Skyhook for this one. I wish there were alternative approaches, you know? Just like when you play the storyline of Grand Theft Auto V, where you usually have one or two approaches for pulling off the heist. Like initially the jewelry store robbery, which is the first one, the Evangelical heist. And then ultimately the finale, of course, is the Union Depository, the big one, where you have one of two choices of how you want to approach setting up the robbery to ultimately taking part of the robbery. So when it comes to doing the salvage yard robberies or mini heists, since I have two gaming avatars, I'll finish up with this one, the female one, and then go to my male avatar and do the heist for those. But those are the ones, of course, you won't see on the screen. Those will be done behind the scenes, you know, off screen. That's a good way to put it, off screen. I don't really get this creator tool stuff, and plus I don't have a Rockstar editor working as I would like. Hopefully it can be resolved. And there's supposed to be some Christmas holiday truck riding around Los Santos. If I look for it, you gotta get right behind it, so it can deliver the goods and gifts and stuff. They said there's even a Yeti in addition to the Gooch, which is GTA's version of the Grinch. And the Gooch will rob you. But I think if you kill the Gooch, he'll kill you. I mean, you get to wear his gear. You get to become the Gooch. Dorado. I think it's a parody of the Dodge Durango. His bravado is actually dodge. I do have the unmarked cruiser, but you can only do so much with it as far as customization goes, to the point that if you get the riot vehicle, you can't do anything with it. So I'm going to avoid it. So here I am. But as always, I'm going to switch into a friends only. So to avoid griefers and whatnot, people who otherwise spoil the GTA experience. I'll need to take a spin on the wheel though too. So before anything, go into preferences, so I can spawn at the casino.
All cool?
Hopefully I can win the prize ride on the podium. And since I have a casino suite, from time to time it does get messy. That's when I'll call the maid to clean it up, to get maid service for free.
Mr. Connors here. May I help you, madam? I'll have a housekeeper sent up immediately.
I tip good. Spin is ready.
Really murder some burger shot.
Upgrade your wardrobe and finally become the person you believe yourself to be. Stop by the casino store and treat yourself.
Come on.
Cab business is not even working.
Hello, I'm sorry, something.
This car is actually outfitted with guns. Left trigger. Left shift button to fire. So as you can see, it's snowing in GTA I think in story mode as well. Or not. Another day, another few dollars.
You all good?
See you on the flip side.
So it's the same approach as I mentioned before.
Okay, so we need to keep my uncle's ship all alone on the water where we can get to her and the port authorities can't sniff us out. But if we want to stop her from being cleared to dock, we need to destroy any trace of authorization, aka torch everything. Oh, and coincidentally, they share the space with the Coast Guard. And what have they got? Uniforms. That getup's gonna help you get real close to the ship if you can grab a fit.
I don't remember saying that. You're
need something, huh? One of your rides? Let me know. I'll bring it to you. Okay, I got stuff to do.
Like the towing into it, the strong burn doesn't have a turbo boost. Which kind of sucks. Plus, the vehicle is difficult to work.
Have info on my uncle's ship. It's called La U Princess. Sticky bombs should do it. And hey, don't forget to grab the Coast Guard's uniform before you pull the trigger. Gotta get suited and booted.
Armament. Guns. Gonna set the bombs and then grab the bag on the way out. Just like before. These setups are the same, as well as the approach to point off this height. It's all the same. But it's gonna get replaced with something called the submarine robbery. So it even has a name. Now for the last bomb, and then I grab the double bag and I'm on way out. So I guess when I get in the car, I'm gonna take it to the scene. Surprisingly enough, these chop shop salvage yard robberies, you can do them by yourself. It's really refreshing to know. Normally, you had to have at least two or three or more people to even get the thing done. There's people who can play the Kyle Cat Eco Heist by themselves. I'm having to rely on other players. you're getting machine torpedoes. They're surface to air.
Later. You all good?
Take it easy.
Gonna be getting the skylift next, but I'm gonna have to be on. Let's see how much a tornado is, and you go to war.cash-and-carry for it, because it's a weaponized vehicle. And war.cash-and-carry is your go-to place for weaponized vehicles. Ooh, 4.25. Still expensive. Let's go and flip the tornado.
That?
I'm gonna go flip the Stromberg. So,
take care.
That's if I get like close to 2 million, that would be awesome.
Good as new.
to. I'm sorry. So, sold. Plenty of sold under here.
Thank you for calling. A driver's on the way.
Where are you going? No problem. My paddle is kissing my metal, so to speak.
Do you love your vehicle? Are you worried something will happen to it? Don't let fear prevent you from getting the most out of life. Take out full coverage insurance with Morse Mutual and we'll replace your vehicle after one quick call. Morse Mutual Insurance is sold at all participating garages.
A courtesy call, how about that?
Hey, asshole! What are you doing? You got...
Get it automatically anyway.
You need a receipt for taxes?
Here with
what the fuck, bro?
Jackass! You looking to get bitch slapped?
You're so full of it.
Oh. Oh my god!
Yeah, you got the stun gun.
Shit!
to my arena.
Mama verga!
Hey, raise up now, motherfucker!
Make her badass, yeah! What's it going to be?
Look at this. 1.7. Yeah.
Sold. To let this one go.
She's going to be dangerous, all right. So, what's up?
Yep, I'll let it go.
Soon.
Tornado.
continue with the salvage yard business and the heist, which is the business on top of it. Stock color is, of course, red.
What can I do? What are we doing then? That looks badass. Good now. That looks badass. Yeah, sexy shit. Looking good.
Come here.
think I just got a heart on. Nice. That looks badass.
This is how much it's worth when you try to resell. 2.6. Much better vehicle than the Stromberg.
Alright, I'm back with some more Let's Play GTA Online, the Chop Shop DLC, Episode 8, Part 1 of 2, the cargo ship robbery. Let's continue, shall we? Okay, what happened to the audio? Let's fix it. One moment. Gonna have to reboot it quickly. Meanwhile, watch this clip. Of course my copy's legit. Probably checking for cracked copies of games. Thank you. I don't know how people scream with one scream. That's why at least I have two. So I'm possibly going to go up on until 7:30 EST. So we're at the last 90 minutes. So let's get through. Maybe we can squeeze this in one stream. Knowing what all I have to do to prep for it. So let's run through it really quick. Get it all in one episode. I'm also making dinner, so I'm making my homemade chicken nugget or chicken nuggets with duck fat, air fried. Make them into bite-sized morsels. I'm gonna make my own honey mustard sauce. That should be pretty good. Jamar sure needs to change up his millennial looking getup. Okay, here we are. But I need to switch lobbies. But I only do friends only lobbies. Otherwise, there's other people trying to kill you. So there's that.
You need something?
Laders.
Yep, let's go through this. Let's see if I got anybody available. You know, I'm gonna do this all by myself. No need to cut nobody in. Next is the Skylar, but that's no problem. Damn it. I selected the wrong thing. I think.
All right, so if you want to get those wheels off that boat, we're gonna need every advantage we can get. Elysian Islands, where it's due to dock. Get there, take some pics, find out what we're getting into. Like, gather those facts, bro, you know? Then we can, like, assess the sitch and make some plans.
I wonder if I did the casing, because I did pay for the ice, but I just didn't do the casing. I don't think. Let's skip this. I do have the turbo procedure.
warship so we can get an idea of the general layout and one of the kind of container they're gonna transport this thing in. Try and get a pick with the locks in it so I know what we're up against. Get a shot of the shipping manifest too so we've got the exact time she's coming in. Might have to look around the offices for that one. Should be good, bro. Should be good. Let's roll. Now we know when this thing is due. Cool. We gotta keep that ship away from the dock, so we're gonna need another boat to reach it.
As you take it when the chairman is active.
Drawing attention. I'll make a note.
Already got this guy.
Yo, you killed it! Got everything we need. Now head to the yard and I'll walk you through the plan. And maybe take a shower or something. Or don't. Maybe you want to smell like fish? That's cool. Someone with as many guns as you can do whatever they want, huh? Okay, bye.
You would kill me, which I'm not gonna. I did it without drawing attention to the Coast Guard. Not the Coast Guard, the freight workers. The longshore. Real.
Now, I didn't need to do this unless I had to. So hopefully, this doesn't reset everything.
Hey, see you around.
Okay, all right, good. So let's just get the Skylar next.
All right, here's the deal. I got the pilot who can get our container off the ship. The thing is, he needs a skylift to lift it. You know, the ones with the huge magnets. That's the kind of equipment Meriwether keeps in stock. You just got to convince him to hand it over.
All right.
know this right. One thing is, I hate doing these missions at night. It's when you're my age. Vision is hard to come by. Oh, it's at the airport this time. Cool. This is a change of location. But the airport is, it's nonetheless secure. That's the cool side. Gotta go in and take it. When I had to go to Fort Vancouver.
to take this guy on.
Are you alright?
Whoa,
Gonna call my pilot and tell him the Skylift is ready. He's gonna love this shit. Way more exciting than taking Yusuf to Vanilla Unicorn and back.
Hello, I'm sorry.
Stop an ammunition and tack up, as I always do, even before heist. Piss off now. He's annoying.
All right.
As I said, much better than the Strongbird, which is also submersible. And amphibious. But at least this has a purple.
Super.
Later I'll stop at the nightclub. Make sure my turn is correct.
You need something?
Take it easy.
To do a disruption mission.
I don't mean to freak you out or anything, but I found out that the air support near my uncle's ship is gonna be heavy. A fleet of Mavericks on patrol. Radio, wipe out! Least we know we won't have any Mavericks up our ass when we hit that ship. You near the boat storage? We still need transport to reach the cargo ship. Now take your pick and tow it back to the yard.
A woman with a rifle and a woman with a dress. How sexy and how cool is that? Sends me a multiplayer request.
I know. Sounds good to me.
Might try to take the boat this time.
Take him down!
I'm gonna drop you!
You dirtbag!
I'll just gas him.
Drop the weapon! Moron! Close in!
For you!
loser! Get a job!
Jerk off! No, I'm not!
get it before the train does. Oh shit, the train's coming. Oh great. This one I fucking hate. Oh shit, the train. Okay. I connected the hitch. He shot me. Alright, we're sick of these assholes.
You're gone! Nuts!
What the? Let's get on with this. 20 minutes. Extended to another hour or so. Two more preps. Thank you. do the other preps quickly. Stay away.
You feel that? Goodbye.
Hey, you know, lifeguards carry a lot of flares, right? Flares that could be used to signal for our pilot to collect a shipping container. Just saying, now's your chance to grab a box.
one more task left.
While you're out there, why don't you check that place for a pair of bolt cutters? We'll need them if we want to break into that container.